Next, I'm going to vacuum the pool. If you don't have this set up, your pool is going to come with taps. If you got an Intex pool, you're going to have a cap something like this. And if you have the strainer, like this type of strainer, you want to put this onto your strainer. If you own a Best Way pool, you're going to have a cap like this, and you're going to have to remove the strainer to put this in. And if you don't have like a, like, your skimmer is going to come with one of these, your Intex skimmer. If you have like a wall skimmer, like a through the wall, you're going to get the skim back plate. And if you have any one of those Intex ones, you're going to have this. Then we're going to remove this. Screw this in its place. And check your pressure too, if your pressure gauge is working. The pressure is good. Then what we're gonna do is we're gonna go back over there, we're gonna set up this vacuum. And I'll have an update for tomorrow how the pool's gonna be. You're gonna unloosen this clamp. Doing everything one-handed. And if you saw my other video, I made a video about the pool like that. I'm gonna make sure this is on tilted to the side. If you're walking this to the, and you want to put this in the area with no algae. And you want to do is make sure you get all the air out of the hose. And check your pressure to your working pressure. I had to remove the slide because I have to get underneath of it. Too much chlorine. You want to make sure you shock it really well and you can have the vacuum. And the algae is dying out too. That means it's going to be a nice clean pool by tomorrow. I'm going to have to run it. Like probably. See? And if you have, let's say, a different way, and that's going to be in the water, make sure you get your pool out of the water. If your pool is like a bigger pool like what I had, you want to jump in and grab it. Make sure you put the pool in a certain area, because there's other ways to actually get the air up. I'm doing a certain way because then we're gonna have to turn the vacuum on. Then we're gonna skim the pool, and it looks like we only need to brush the wall. Probably have to brush the wall. Then you're gonna have suction on one. with the caps, you want to remove the strainer, move the strainer grate if you're in Texas. You remove this grate, move this like this, move this, just this cover on a 4-inch hex tool. If you have, move it like this, 4-inch hex tool, and cap it on here. Best way, you want to move the whole thing. You want to unloosen the clamp. Then you're going to turn this off. And it's going to suck more and water on one, and you're going to vacuum all this stuff. Yarn a little bit of dirt. Make sure you get all the dirt out. There's a lot of wrinkles in my pool, that's why they're hard to move. You get all this algae out and you have to shock it. The dairy's a little, we have to shock it a little more. If your pump is different, if you have a saltwater pool, you want to put it on boost. Just getting the algae out. You got an area with a bigger slope than you is. Put the area and brush it like that. Because we're going to brush the pool out in my next video, we're going to all just sit and brush the pool, any trash out, and make sure so we're going to have to backwash the filter. That's going to be like probably today. We'll do everything that we can to save the pool out drain, because without draining this down, and I'm using a smaller system too. I do everything I can to save it. Not draining it down. We're gonna have to let all this sit for a while. After this, we're gonna have to backwash, and we're gonna vacuum the pool again. And make sure, because there's a little bit more algae, we have to let this sit for a while. You can add algaecide also, if you have any algaecide. You can check for any slip. Any dirt or any trash too. Sometimes we will find your corners too, but that's what the corner brush is gonna be for.
I think I might
hook up the corner brush. And make sure when all this pool, make sure the pool is clean too. And it's getting really clean too. And make sure you got so much trash. It might be cloudy for a few days, but that's all normal. And sometimes, if you don't hook it up really well, this is going to happen. But it's all normal. Try to vacuum this, but because there's no weight holding this hose down, then what we're gonna do is we're gonna let it sit. That's time for a quick backwash. Make sure that's sitting on the ground, and make sure this hose is also in this area. and make sure you're gonna vacuum. Make sure this is all when you're down because there's a lot of wrinkles in my pool. Because you can't get a lot of dirt, like it's gonna. If you got like heavier debris, you wanna make sure. Then. Next is going to be a backwash. That's going to be next. Then, if you have anything like something a little bigger, you want to try to grab it out. Like this is, don't even know what this is here. But I did not got picked up with the pump. We're gonna let this filter for a while, then we're gonna backwash. We're going to backwash the filter. We're gonna check the pressure and we're gonna backwash. We're gonna check the pressure too. Backwash the same filter. The pressure was really high. There's algae in here with the backwash. And remove any rubber seals. I'll fill it off to see what's in, see what came out of the pool. I'm gonna make sure, because if it turns not green, I'm gonna make sure. If your filter has a waste, you don't have to put it on waste. But if you want to like make your sand last longer, you have to put in waste. Then backwash. And always turn off your pump before you put it on backwash. So I'll set the camera on the tripod. Put it on something, make it to see what's coming out of the funky hose. Okay, we're gonna go fill up the pool because we are wasting water. We wanna make sure we have more water. If yours is a cartridge, you want to clean the cartridge off. We're wasting a lot of water. You are filling up the pool too. And see what's coming out when you plug this system in. See what's gonna come out? look how murky and dirty the water is. Now it's clearing up. So unplug it and put it on rinse. I'll be over here, gonna turn it on for rinse. You don't want to put it on filter. You have to rinse in excess what's out of there. The water is still a little murky. Our backwash too. Rinsing out the sand. Clean. Then what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna disconnect the vacuum and I'll put it back on filter. Plug it in. That's a lot of dirt, dirty, there's a lot of really dirty in here, but we're gonna brush it. And that's gonna be, we're gonna brush the pool. We're gonna disconnect the vacuum and we're gonna brush the pool. When we're brushing it, we're gonna turn this off. And we're gonna brush any excess debris out of the pool. Then we're gonna go back to, after that, we're gonna go back to the vacuum. Okay. We're gonna have all this, disconnect this hose. We're gonna keep that connected until later, and then we're gonna all disconnect it. Take this vacuum hose out. Take this vacuum out. We keep this hose in there. We have the brush for it in the pool. And we have the equipment running. Make sure it fills up because you do. Any filter, you want to put it more towards waste. If your filter doesn't option a waste, you probably want to directly filter it from the filter and have to change out the media. Or if your filter has waste, then you're gonna keep it all. See, that's gonna loosen what's all left in there. We're losing a lot of dirt, and sometimes the corners, there's dirt in the corners. And we're gonna also empty the pump basket. Have a nice clean pump basket for later. We're doing everything now. me now. I don't have to like do all of it tomorrow. You're gonna filter all this out, and you're gonna have to filter it out probably for like maybe a while. I don't know. Like, is how big is your pool? Mine, I'm gonna filter it out probably for maybe like two, probably. And I'm gonna let it settle. Then I'm gonna turn it back on. Backwash. You probably have to backwash your filter mate probably like today and tomorrow. Loosen all the dirt off too when you're on it, because if you're loosening all this dirt, it's gonna be easier to vacuum next time. You're gonna let this all settle. You take everything out, you're gonna let all this settle. Then by tomorrow, by later, I'll have a nice clean pool to save swimming tomorrow. It'll be backwashing the filter and keeping everything on, because I'm at the backwash and I'm going to skim the whole pool, clean it all up, and I'll be all it. And make sure to check for any other things. It's clearing up. We'll let it settle for a little bit, and we'll have this pool cleared up. Have it ready by tomorrow.